welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kate. And I'm excited. I am excited. I can't help it. I've got another Williams Brothers one. Well, I've got two Williams Brothers, but I will tell you about them in... I'll tell you about them both now. Because they both need mentioning. Firstly, I think I'll tell you about... No, I think I'll tell you about the Alba first. There's the Alba, which I'll show you all round later on. But that's the Scotch Pine Ale. Now, unless I'm mistaken, beers from the kind of 17th century onwards were, since the nun Hildegard von Bingen started putting hops into beers and that, and using that to preserve the beers and kind of also as a relaxing thing, they used to be either brewed with pine, with heather, with all sorts of other things to kind of bitter off and balance with the malts a little bit. Now, that said, when the hops did get taken all around Europe and everything and taken into brewing, there was still a kind of holding back in certain places because in, say, Scotland, there were certain things to do with economics and also to do with politics and wars and battles and God knows what else that was kind of making it a bit more difficult for the hops to be going across the border and everything, you know. And I'm not sure how well hops grow north of the border. But that said, I should think they grow okay because... And where are we? On to this beer. We've got Kelpie. This is one I'm going to be doing now. Seaweed Ale. Now, this is grown... this is where I'll read it. Prior to the 1850s, many Scottish coastal ale houses brewed their own ales. I have to say ale because it's ale otherwise. Using local malted barley. So they can malt barley up there, or they malt it, I don't know whether they grow it, I would imagine so, on fields fertilised with seaweed. Now it's very rich in kind of ions and all sorts of stuff, minerals and all that, and it, with anything that if you're kind of feeding food to livestock and stuff, you know, like Parma ham with the curds and whey from the Parma cheese or the Parmesan cheese, they take on a certain amount of that flavour as they eat it. And the same with plants as well, they take on certain flavours, certain nutrients from what they're being fed as well. So if you mix something really rancid and horrible, they can take that up. Not always, but you know, they do act as a filter a little bit to a certain extent. But they take on a lot of the kind of, certainly a lot of the minerals and things will pass over in the flavour. I do digress. But that goes to freedom anyway. And also, you've got, I love this. I just love the name Bladderwreck. Sounds like when you really like got an attack of you want to go to the toilet and you go, oh, what's the matter? I've got bladder wreck. Anyway, seaweed. We have recreated the unique flavour of this traditional ale with the inclusion of fresh seaweed bladder wreck, which is taken from the water on the Argyll coast and mashed in with the malted and roasted barley. Kelpie is rich, I don't want all that, blah, 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 I don't want the rest of that. Try your best, if possible, don't read any of the flavour things before. Don't go on kind of beer.com or whatever they're called and kind of read up on the notes and that. They're all right for reading the notes and history and taste notes, I mean, and history and everything afterwards. Don't read them before and in taste, because it leads you along in different directions that you might not have even tasted, you know. And I think if a beer doesn't taste of what it's supposed to taste of without being nudged towards it, then it ain't doing its job, you know. So if it tastes of certain things, I want it to taste of those things without being told to taste them, if you know what I mean. I hope that doesn't sound kind of like, you know, here's the crown there. Oh my word, this is going to be lovely. Right, that goes up in empty bottle cap jingle. I'll put them in the bag. Oh, I'm getting excited already. I do that over certain beers when I know I've got a good brewery and I'm expecting a good beer. I feel my heart going boogity boogity book, you know. I've lost some of the smells, the aromas. I've lost some of them off the thing. They've kind of escaped quickly. I don't know if you've noticed, I'm starting to kind of pour heads in. This is not really holding on to the head that much. So I'll show you quick. There's the head there. It's kind of dissipating quite quickly. But I don't mind that at all, because it's still sparkling away on the surface. Tick, 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 tick. You know, one that like that backwards rain. You know when rain's in a puddle and you see little tick, tick, little tiny spikes. Well, it's doing that in reverse as the bubbles come pinning up. There's the down the side of the glass, the carbonation. So there's plenty of that going on. It's running through quite quickly. But I'm not really, that usually kind of sends up signals to me of like, oh, thin beer. But I'm not really that worried with Williams Brothers, because apart from the Cayley, which was a lovely, good lager, but I didn't really like it. But it was a good lager, and loads of people will like it, so I would still suggest go ahead with it. Apart from that, everything else I've ever tried with Williams Brothers has been wow, you know. So I'm looking forward to this. So smell. Oh, let's show you through the. Have I got my little torch? Have I got my little torch? As the girl's been, I've got my little baby gets hold of it and whoa, off she goes. I made the mistake of showing her how to use it one day. Here we go. You twist that. Whoa. My little tools that I take on like tastings and things. Right, that's what we're getting through it. Kind of a very deep red, very, very, very deep red. Right, cheers. Oh, smell. Now you're getting almost kind of like almost Guinnessy sort of aromas, almost like kind of a stout aroma. Yeah, almost kind of a almost kind of a porridgey sort of oaty smell in there. You're getting grains, but the smell isn't as pretty as I was expecting. Let's taste it. Oh, that's complex. Oh, wow. That is very weird. Mmm. Oh, got, wow. It grows. You've got a saltiness, a mineral kind of high, rich, spinachy sort of saltiness in there. Yeah, really kind of a high, rich mineral content in there. Which is, it's kind of a it's weird. you can taste the kind of some of the predominant tastes before this weird one comes up and goes hee hee hee. The predominant tastes are you've got a kind of nice mocha sort of note going on there, a lovely little relaxing mocha note. Little hints of fennel in there as well. Oh, that's a weird note. And it is wonderful, weird and wonderful. I'm going in again. This will all be gone in a minute. Mmm. This is really complex. So now, sometimes I hate the fact that I've got to try to push these in as quick a time as possible, because I've gone rambling on into 11 minutes and I'm getting nowhere near getting these flavours out to you. There's a background of an Earl Grey tea, kind of that bergamot background. A thyme, like T-H, sorry, way I spell, speak, T-H-Y-M-E, that sort of thyme note in there. When you get that in cooking and that little thyme note. Almost a rosemary as well. Mmm. Now, I believe thyme and rosemary are quite high in like ferrous content and that, iron content. So it may go along with the seaweed and that. I don't know, because I'm sure that's high in iron content and that. I do like that. I really do like that. It's one of them that's going to sell. I hate to kind of be like say I'm the connoisseur and all that business, but I think it might sell past people if you're not sitting there really taking it in. You know, it's not one of them that's shouting woo woo over here woo. You know, it's kind of sitting there really just subdued and that, but it's got something to say. And it's really quiet, but it's got something to say. But you, if you're gulping them down, you ain't gonna notice it. Excuse me. Yeah, would I say buy it and try it? Yeah, buy it and try it. Another lovely ale from the Williams brothers. They really know what they're doing. They really do. And now I'm really looking forward to this one. Okay, bottoms up. Cheers, chin chin. And I think Scotland, I think Slungy. Bye.